somebody in my family or my friends or even my boyfriend thought that it was a good idea. They said, like, what are you going to do all by yourself in Amsterdam, in this school? I mean, you're 18, it's your first time that you'll be alone. But I decided to do it anyway. And that was very odd of me, because I really tend to be very influenced by what the other people think. And so that was the first sign that something was changing in me, even before to come here.
Thank you, thank you. This was Diletta, or this is still Diletta, because he's still alive. She attended the Nomads summer school last July in Amsterdam, together with 15 other people from five different countries. And to use her as an example, I want to talk to you today about human being and how we became more and more from human being into human doings. Because we lost the kind of way of looking at life from a child perspective. We lost the openness, we lost the curiosity, we lost the way of going forward on a different way. And I want to invite you to read, and maybe I'm going to read it for you, if it's big enough on the monitor, the next poem of Nick Askew. And it's called Truth, Freedom, End. And you will get the last part of the poem you will get in the end. It's 2 a.m. You're wide awake, feeling alone, feeling unseen, and inexplicably lost. Discontent despite all that you have around you. The people, your life, your dreams. You wear a face that tells the world that you're okay, but you're not. You're bone achingly tired from the relentless game of belonging. You long for a meaningful place in the world and to belong without condition. Without struggle, you long to be seen. When you were a child, you were an ultimate human being. You were. You were hearing, feeling, sensing everything around you, and you were directed from inside out. You were open, and you were actually, you were the example of freedom. You tried stuff, you were open, you were curious, you were in the moment, and you were really, really trying to get everything out. You can remember this, because when you were a little child, when you started walking, after 50 times trying to walk, you didn't decide after 50 times, this walking is nothing for me, I'm going to quit. So you had the curiosity, you had the strength to do it. So it is still in your bones. And what happened actually is that it changed. It changed from outside in. It changed from like, hey, what's out there? What is expected of me? What do I need to do differently? And actually what happened is that the starting point of freedom changed into fear. The fear which came through the surrounding, through education, through your parents, to everybody around. And actually, it was being told to you a lot of times, like, this is how you need to do it. This is how we do it. This is what boys do. This is what girls do. This is how you need to do it. And slowly, slowly, what happened is that you started being directed from outside in, instead from inside out. And then, it's going to be a very happy talk, so don't bear with me. What started is actually that you started also feeling the pain of not being good enough. And this is one of the major important things, together with something else, which makes you start doubting what you want to do. Because you're not good enough and you need to be better. And you start feeling the pain about it. And then you try to fit in and try to be as good as possible, to go for all the yeses from the outside. Well, actually, maybe you want to do something else. And slowly, slowly, what is changing in our heads, also in my head, is that fear takes over. The starting point is fear. And actually, something else also comes. So next to that, you think that you're not good enough because you constantly hear all kind of stuff in education, in school, concerning to exams, concerning to everything. You hear that you're not good enough. Next to that, everybody here in this room also has the need to be seen for who he or she really is. And then, if you would do that, then you know that actually you don't fit in. It's not good enough. And then, next to that, it becomes even worse because competition hits in. What's happening is that you are in a working place or still in school, between 5 and 25 years old, you're in school. And then what happens is that you're not good enough and that you need to fit in. The happy part is almost there. So what is happening actually is that I have a daughter of 4 years old, a daughter of 9 years old, and they represented freedom as they were. They went to school, and on a certain moment, they need to raise their finger to go to the toilet, which is very strange, because when you were at home, you never raised fingers. Can I go to the toilet? Or even worse, that at 12:30, there's a bell ringing, and then it's lunchtime. Then you need to be hungry. Well, actually, it's not allowed to eat a sandwich at 11 o'clock, which is really strange. I also think that in 20 years from now, we will look at it and think like, a little bit strange to ring a bell and then to have lunchtime. So this competition, it really, really hit in. And then we started assuming that fear is the starting point. And assumptions are the mother of all fuck-ups. If you are assuming stuff, then you're going to do strange things. Also, then you're afraid of looking stupid, you're afraid to lose, you're afraid to stepping in, to really do stuff. And this became actually the starting point. But there's the B again. Actually, it is like we can choose today to start from human being instead of human doing. We can start from saying, okay, this is who I am, this is what I want to do, and this is my connection with the outside world. And then what will happen is for sure that you will do stuff which really, really matters. Because by being, by really starting to be who you really are, people are connecting to you, for sure. And this is one of the major starting points also in my school in Amsterdam, that if you are open, if you are curious, if you open yourself up, then the connections will come, for sure. People will connect to you. People will connect to you on a feeling level, on a freedom level, not on a fear level. So my invitation for today, this is the happy part, my invitation for today is that we start really seeing ourselves again. Starting point, this little child, which was 4 or 5 years old. And I know that it's in everybody here in the room, because we all were kids. And it's in our bones. And how do I know that? I have a nerve disease. I walk a little bit strange, and my hands are a little bit, it's a little bit difficult for me. But I'm going to a haptonomist. And a haptonomist is, she is teaching me that the wisdom of my muscles and of my nerve system is in my, it's in me. Because when I was 13, I got the disease. But before that, I was walking perfectly, there was nothing wrong. So what she does is she constantly tries to make the connection with the little boy from 13 years on back to 4 or 5 years old. And there's exercises for that. In real life, there's also exercises for that for us. Call it mindfulness, call it yoga, call it whatever, but it is in us. So my invitation is to start today, and not only today, but start today, as a starting point, to see yourself again, to feel yourself again, to hear yourself again, to sense yourself again, and to use your intuition. As a kid, you only used your intuition. And start with curiosity. What is there is there. This is what you thought when you were a kid. So to first go back to human being again, to be again. And then what you are going to do, what you will start to do, will matter for sure. Because if you make the connection with your free self, Then, and which is not always an easy thing, if you make the connection with your free self, then it's also possible to make a connection with the other one and with the environment. And then for sure, you're not going to sell Kalashnikovs. You're going to do really great stuff because you have a good connection with yourself. And then the environment will also help. Okay, I want to invite you to, I'm going to read the last part of the poem of Nick Askew. And then I want to ask you to do, to make a fist. With two hands, really make fists and really press your fists. All of you. Yeah, now. Now. So if you make this fist, and what I will do is I will read this poem, and you can also read along. You can also close your eyes, and then slowly, slowly release, like really, really, really push your fist, and then slowly, slowly, during the reading, release your fists into a free hand again. The invitation. There's a place beyond right and wrong. A place beyond the endless game of fixing what is seemingly broken. Beyond all your best efforts to make this life work and to make your life's work matter. It's here that you're faced with the unfiltered voice of your own soul, your free soul. A voice so unafraid that it'll tell you of your place in the world, of purpose and unquestionable clarity, and of your belonging without any condition. It's here that personal revelation can transform vulnerability into vivid displays of courage and of strength. In service to profound connectedness and meaningful life. I know where this place is and how to go there. Let's travel together. Let's explore in the most profound of senses.
Now that I'm finishing this experience, because it's about to come to the end, I feel really so empowered of myself. I feel like invictus, it's a Latin word, and it's invisible. And I'm really so grateful to all the people that I've known here. I really discovered beautiful souls, really similar to mine, and this is something that really doesn't happen every day. And I really needed it. And I have this feeling that something tremendous is going to happen in my life, something great. And I can't wait to to discover it. So, yeah.
So the question is, today, tomorrow, you can feel the possibility in your body for sure. And you can also feel the fear in your head. And the question is, what's next? What is your next step to make the connection with freedom again and to step into possibility and to connect to your heart and to feel the passion for the thing which you want to bring into the world? This is my invitation for you. Thank you very much. Grazie mille.